back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to be doing a makeup tutorial on this look that you see here using all of ColourPop's. This is the Boudoir Noir. I think that's how you pronunciate the name. And this is the Excuse My French set. And I recently got my hands on this. This runs for $32, so it's really affordable. And I love the idea that it comes with a blush, a lip oil, and an eyeshadow palette. Basically everything that you need to create a look. And I thought this would be a really great gift maybe for yourself or maybe a gift for someone else, especially because the holidays are around the corner. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. As always, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more videos just like this one. And let's jump on in and get ready for a day. I've already prepped my skin, applied my moisturizer, eye cream, and a little bit of the Winky Lips Lip Sleepy Mask on my lips to really help them, you know, be nice and moisturized. You guys, the weather out here in LA lately has been really, really dry. And your girl here needs all the moisture in the world, which is so crazy because I usually never deal with dryness. But this year, girl, came in full effect, okay? So we're gonna go ahead and jump on into foundation. This is typically the next step that I go into. And I'm gonna be using my all-time favorite foundation, you guys. This is the CoverGirl True Blend Matte Made, and this is in the shade M10. And I'm gonna go ahead and use it Cosmetics Precision Brush. It's basically my foundation brush that I use. And I'm gonna go ahead and apply 2 pumps of foundation on my brush, and then apply the foundation on the top of my cheekbones. And then anything that I have left over, I'm gonna go ahead and pat it all around my face as well as my neckline, and then just blending everything out. Concealer, I'm gonna go into the Dose of Colors Meet Your Hue, and this is in the shade 11 Light Medium. You guys, I just bought a new camera, so I'm still getting used to how to use it. And to be honest, I thought this part was filming and it wasn't. So as you can tell, I've already applied concealer on my face, on the chin, upper lip, down the bridge of the nose, forehead, and under the eye area. So next, I'm just gonna go in with my beauty blender and I'm just gonna go ahead and blend everything out, and then we'll move on to setting the areas on our face. Moving on into setting the areas on our face that, you know, we've applied a concealer, I'm gonna go into the Dermablend Professional. This is the Illuminating Banana Powder. And you guys, it's kind of expensive, but if you can find it on sale, there's any deals out there, especially around the holidays, I would definitely suggest you guys to try this out. It's really, really nice. I personally really like it. And I'm gonna be using my BH Cosmetics brush, picking up a little bit of the powder, and then I'm just gonna go ahead and set the areas all around my face where I've applied concealer. To set the rest of the areas on our face where we have, you know, foundation, I'm gonna be using the Ciate London. This is Extraordinary Translucent Powder, you guys. It's so beautiful. I feel like it gives me like an airbrushed finish, and I came across this, I think it was BoxyCharm's unboxing, probably like a month or two ago. It is so good. If you haven't tried it out, definitely try it out. So I'm gonna be using my Crystal Zodiac brush from the BH Cosmetics collection, and I'm going to pick up a little bit of that powder on my brush, and then I'm just going to go ahead and set the areas where we have applied foundation all around our face. With the same brush, you guys, I'm going to go into my MAC Studio Fix. This is in the shade C4, and I'm going to go ahead and pick up a little bit of that powder, and on the neck area, I'm going to go ahead and set that out just because I want it to blend all seamlessly, and I don't want it to be so noticeable that I've applied foundation in that area, and as well apply a little bit of the powder on the top of my cheekbones just because that's where I have my hyperpigmentation, and I really want to make sure it's really covered. So even though we use the Ciate London, I just need a little bit more coverage, so I'm just gonna apply a little bit of powder there. To contour, I'm gonna go into the Clinique. This is the Sunkissed Perfection Palette, and I'm gonna go into Get Bronzed. Right now, I feel like I'm pretty fair, so some of the bronzers that I was using before are a little too dark for my liking, and I don't want it to be so obvious that I'm contouring. I want a light, natural contour. That's what I mean. So I'm gonna go into Get Bronzed, and I'm gonna use my BH Cosmetics brush, and I'm just gonna go ahead and contour down the side of the cheekbone, down the side of the forehead and jawline area, connecting everything together, and then blending everything out down my neck. My brows off camera, you guys. So the brow pencil that I use is from Hourglass. This is called the Brow Micro Sculpting Pencil, and this is in the shade Natural Black, and I just figured using it just because, you know, my roots have gone out and my hair is pretty dark right now, so that is what I used. And for brow gel, I went to the iHeart Revolution brow gel, and I actually really like this. I don't remember which like collection it's from, but it's a clear brow gel. It looks pretty dirty now because, you know, I've been using it for a while. So we're gonna move on to our eyes. Eyes, you guys, I'm gonna go in to the Pero Primero primer. This is a long wearing sticky base primer. I've been trying this out. I recently got this in my BoxyCharm monthly subscription, and it's so good. I'm still figuring out like how to use this because it's so new to me, but I really like it. It definitely blends out my eyeshadow really well, and it really makes the pigmentation of the eyeshadows really stand out. So I really love it. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply a little bit of this base on a brush and then brush it all over the lid. And I only apply a very small amount. I don't really feel like you need a lot. I feel like a tiny, like just a little tiny bit. And then you're just gonna go ahead and brush it over all around the lid. To our eyes, and I'm gonna go into our palette, Boudoir Noir, I think that's how you say it. And this is a really nice size, you guys. I really love the size to this palette. And the back of it, it also lists all of the eyeshadows and their names on there. So I really like that they do that. So it's a nice little reference to, you know, what the shade is called. And it has a really nice size mirror, which I really love. It's a really good size, especially if you're traveling. And here is the palette, you guys. Isn't it beautiful? Totally my tones and my color scheme. I really, really love these shades. It's kind of boring, but for me, it's like all what I'm looking for and more. So we're gonna go into Deja Vu, this really pretty vanilla shade. And I'm gonna go ahead with a fluffy shadow brush. I'm gonna go ahead and brush a little bit of that shadow all around the lid and then move on to our crease shade. Transition shade, I'm gonna go into Desire, this really pretty kind of mustardy green shade. And I'm gonna use my Farrah. This is a tapered blending brush. And I'm gonna pick up a little bit of that eyeshadow. Then I'm gonna go ahead and apply it within the crease of the lid, blending it out, doing windshield wiper motion. Going into Latex, I will say, you guys, this really pretty green shade. There's a lot of fallout, so that's the only thing I'm going to be seeing so far. I don't know if it's just with this eyeshadow. I didn't notice it as much going into Desire, but Latex, girl, he's falling out everywhere. So I'm just going to be using my BH Cosmetics brush. This is a blending brush. Pick up a little bit of that shadow and apply it in the corner of the eye, dabbing it in, building color, and then blending it within the crease of the lid. I go ahead and smoke out the bottom lash line, and I'm going to be going into Desire, picking up a little bit of that shadow, and then dabbing the shadow on the lash line area, making sure everything is really blended. And I rather pack it on than blend it out, just because I don't want any fallout. Then going into Latex, pick up a little bit of that shadow and apply it on the lash line area, building color and connecting it to the corner of the eye. As for liner, you guys, I actually went in with an angled brow brush and I picked up a little bit of Hot Toddy. It's this really dark green, but it almost looks kind of like charcoal. And I picked up a little bit of that eyeshadow and applied it in the inner lining of the eye. So I'm gonna go ahead and move on to our last and final step, or one of. I'm kind of playing around with colors today, so I'm not really sure where I'm going with this look, but I wanna try Sleep in this really beautiful gold shade. I'm gonna dab my finger into the shadow, and then I'm gonna go ahead and apply it within the center of the lid, dabbing the shadow all around. Love the gold. I didn't expect it to be this pigmented, but you know, it's okay. It's still really beautiful. I'm gonna go ahead and blend out the edges of the gold eyeshadow just to make sure everything is blended really nicely. And then I'm gonna move on to curling my lashes. And you guys already know the drill. I'm gonna be using my most favorite eyelash curler at the time. This is a Shiseido eyelash curler. Then I'm gonna go in with my all-time favorite Super Lash mascara. We'll have everything linked down below in case you guys are interested. And then we'll move on, you know, to applying blush, our lips, and basically completing this look. Blush, you guys, I'm gonna go into Love Story, and this is the blush color that comes with this set. And let me show you really quickly. So it's a really nice size pan. It has a mirror to it as well. And I really love this shade. It looks like in person, like it has a little bit of like shimmer in it, but not a lot. I don't think you're gonna see it on camera. So let me swatch in the back of my hand really quickly. But I feel like it's gonna be a really pretty kind of mauvey, rosy type of blush, very neutral, which I really love. You guys know I love a neutral toned blush. So let me show you. I keep rambling on, but I don't show you. Here it is. I don't think you'll see it swatched on the back of my hand. Let me show you. I hope you guys can see it focusing on camera, but it's a really pretty kind of rosy blush. I personally really like it. So I'm gonna go in using my BH Cosmetics brush, pick up a little bit of this blush shade and apply it on top of my cheekbones, doing like little dabby, circular, applying it in circular motions, dabbing it into the skin, you guys. On my lips, I went in with the Milani Understatement Lip Liner, and this is in the shade number 120, French Rose. I lined my lips, and in the corners of the mouth, I kind of shaded it in and left the center of the lips, you know, with nothing on. And on this under lips, you guys, I went in with the Luxe. This is the ColourPop Luxe Lip Oil, and this is the shade First Date. This is the lip oil that comes within our set, you guys, and it has a really nice scent to it. It smells really yummy. It's soft, but it's not strong and overpowering, which I really like. And I just applied it on the center of the lips. And you guys, it feels really moisturizing. Doesn't feel oily and greasy, but it feels really moisturizing. I don't know. I just really like it. And I love the shine that it gives. I feel like it definitely completed this look. Basically sums up today's makeup tutorial, guys. I have used all of the products that came in this Boudoir Noir collection or set. I personally really liked everything that I received. The only thing, you guys, is the eyeshadow palette definitely has a little bit of a fallout, or a good amount of fallout, when it comes to certain eyeshadows in this palette, especially what is it called, Latex. It had a lot of fallout, you guys. That is the only thing, and you guys know I'm not a huge fan of it, but when it comes to like the pigmentation, it definitely is really pigmented, so I kind of give it like the benefit of the doubt or the pass on this palette as well. I really love the eyeshadows. They're all really pigmented. They blended out really, really nicely. And that gold shimmery shade is really, really beautiful. I really loved it. And the blush, there was no fallout to this blush. It's a really pretty natural blush shade, and I really like it. And I just felt like it just went so well with today's look, especially the lip oil. Granted, it's not as pigmented as I'd like, but you know, using a lip liner and kind of, you know, working with what you have, you can definitely use this, and you know, it's gonna be really pretty. I really love the shine that it gives. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's makeup tutorial. If you guys have any questions on any of the products that I use, comment down below, ask away, and I'll do my best to answer your questions. As always, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more videos just like this one. And I will see you guys all in my next video. Love you guys so, so much. Bye!